Hey YouTube, Kira Twig here, bringing you all another one of my Yu-Gi-Oh! Discussion videos. Today we're going to be talking about cards that I feel need to be reprinted, but cards that I also feel that I want personally reprinted. These are cards that have never received a reprint ever since they were first released, cards that have been out for quite a while now, cards we got recently that I feel with support we have for the decks and just the overall popularity of the decks, I feel definitely do deserve a reprint. These are in no way in any order of cards I feel that you need, you know, reprints of importance, just, you know, a specific order to talk about. So let's go ahead and get started with the video. To start off, for the cards we have, probably one of the most requested reprints of all, and that is Elemental Hero Air Neos. This card was released in the Strike of Neos booster pack, and it is one of the only Neos fusions that has not received a reprint of all the cards. We had ones that were very easy to gain access to, like Grand Neos having its own tin. We had ones like Flare Neos and Aqua Neos reprinted in duelist packs. No love was given to Air Neos as such, even in cards like the Legendary Collections. There were ones like Glow Neos that received a reprint. This card never got that treatment. If it were to actually receive a reprint, I think it would be very well deserving in the new Battles of Legend we receive this summer. We get a bunch of cool secret rare cards. I think giving Air Neos the secret rare treatment would definitely be well deserving, since this card was originally released in the Strike of Neos, I believe, as a ultra rare and an ultimate rare. So just giving it a different rarity as such, I think anything less than that isn't really deserving of this card. With the price range it's hit, and with Neos support being such a big thing nowadays, this card definitely does deserve that reprint mark, for the sole fact that with all the new cards like Neos Fusion, Next, you name it, we would just need more reason to run Air Hummingbird and not have to proxy an Air Neos just because of the huge dollar price that this card has on its tag at the moment. So if we see it, I think it'll definitely give a lot of GX fans incentive to buy the Battles of Legend, just for the fact that it'll be much easier to get this card as well. Some other ones that we have. Like I said, there was really no order in this. I just really went off the top of my head of cards that I feel are deserving of reprints. Medulce Magellin being one of these cards. Now, the Medulces themselves haven't really gotten too many reprints when it comes down to all the cards. I think some of them, like Hootcake, have gotten Megatin reprints, but those have really affected their prices. Cards like Magellin came out in Return of the Duelist, and they haven't really seen any reprint. And because of it, the price of the card has definitely been affected. Unlike cards like Air Neos, where you really only need like one to run in the deck to make it playable, cards like Magellin, you definitely do need a playset of. And with the dollar marks on her being a big factor, and the fact that Medulces have received just as much support in the newer sets recently, compared to cards like Elemental Heroes, we've had at least, I think, one card for Medulces in each booster pack. If they're going to keep giving us support and, you know, reasons to build the decks, they should at least make it a little more easier for the cards to also be reprinted and used. I know they gave us some effect monsters, but we need some of these more basic staple cards like Magellin to at least make the, you know, decks work better and not have to pay over, you know, $15 a card for cards like this. It's not just Magellin. Angeli, even though she, I believe, was reprinted in the Megatin, not that easy to find those, you know, cards either anymore, and just as difficult to get a playset of that card. But Magellin's been around a lot longer, and I feel, you know, it's time for a reprint, definitely. Whether it be even just a common in an OTS pack, this card definitely does need the reprint very soon. Another one, this is just a personal preference of mine, but, you know, sometimes maybe overlooked. Not just Naturia Cherries, but the whole Naturia lineup. I know there are some decks out there that haven't really gotten the reprints because they've been overlooked by other decks that stay more relevant into the meta, with Naturias being one. You know, you can also even compare Naturias to Gen X. Maybe we haven't seen any Gen X reprints lately. But cards like Naturia Cherries released in Star Trek Blast, which this pack didn't have any reprints for a good while, but we've seen cards like Dragoon Community of Azrayana, cards like Drolan Lockbird, all reprinted back into circulation, but a lot of cards still overlooked like this. This is, you know, actually sort of a usable card on its own for decks just to consistently get out monsters. So just, you know, maybe one of those Dark Horse cards we could see reprinted later on. In a smaller pack, we've seen cards reprinted that, you know, in Hidden Arsenal-like packs like the Infinity Chasers have these, you know, random cards that might mix in. So if we maybe do receive some plant support later on, we might see this card reprinted in that set as well. We were talking about the Neos support. I might have brought this up a little earlier with Air Neos, but Neos Knight, we have some newer fusions for Neos that are probably a lot more consistent than Neos Knight, but still, this card was reprinted never. It was released in Extreme Victory, and ever since then, it's been kind of a go-to card for the Elemental Hero support with Neos revolving around needing a Warrior-type monster and Neos to make it. And it was one of the polymerization cards, so very easy to get out fusion-wise. You can even use Aqua Dolphin and this card to make it. But I'm very surprised that this card in packs like Shadows of Valhalla, where we've seen, you know, reprints of Elemental Hero Neos, we've seen Flare Scarab, Glow Moss, all reprinted in foil versions, just to see this card tag along as an additional reprint shocked me very much so, along with Air Neos, obviously, because that card was definitely deserving of the reprint way more than this card, but still the fact that this card also remains unprinted, very shocking indeed. I think we've seen plenty of other bigger ones, like Magma Neos reprinted. Just some of these ones that are overlooked, unless they have plans for them later on. Like I said, there are some newer Neos fusions that use polymerization that are much better than this card especially, but just giving us that extra option in the extra deck, definitely a helpful there for sure. Now, I was thinking of other suggestions, and a big theme you'll see with the rest of the video is that a lot of these reprints are secret rare. You've seen other super rares that are either just easier to gain access to, but when it comes down to a card being secret rare, it just makes it that much more difficult to, you know, purchase the card, or at least find it. And Mystic Piper is one of these cards. Just going around trade binder wise, I never see this card in anyone's binder, just for the fact that it came out in Extreme Victory. It's an older set before the Zexal era started. This was the last 5Ds pack, and it was just a staple card, something I would have thought seen maybe printed in a structure deck. If anything, we would have seen cards like Kinkabyo reprinted plenty of times, Swift Scarecrow, just a level one staple to tribute and reveal a level one monster, was used a lot in Exodia kind of decks, level one decks, you name it. It's not like it's specifically made for any type of deck. It's that generic type of card that I thought I would have seen at least sometime or later in a structure deck release, or even, you know, a battle pack that got released multiple times after this card. The fact that we didn't see it, and the fact that I think it was one of Yusei's main cards that he used in his deck. If I'm wrong, you can correct me on that, but I do believe that was the case. To see something like this, maybe even in the, you know, 5D's Legendary Collection, when it wasn't in that, that is what shocked me the most as well with this card also. Now, going to the Shadal support, and I said we're also sticking to the theme of secret rares for a good amount of these cards. El Shadal Eniel Tillis, I believe is how you pronounce this card. We've seen a lot of reprints on many of the Shadal fusions, including El Shadal Winda, Construct, you name it. This is more of a specific type of secret rare that focuses on shutting down, you know, cards that use spell and traps, but still the fact that this card was released in, I believe, Cross Souls, and we've seen plenty of reprints from that set, including Ghost Ogre, Clearwing Synchro Dragon cover card, more obviously, but we still have some secret rares that were overlooked. This card was never reprinted in the Megaton. They always overlook some of these cards, and those cards seem to be the ones that end up, you know, going the long while not having a reprint. With more Shadal, if Construct and other cards become more relevant, with Construct being released off the list and people become more aware of this, or if we have more threats from decks like Rituals that need some sort of answer when you play the deck, I can see this being a card that needs more easier access for people to play. I don't know what this card's going for, and currently I don't think it's too expensive, but still, you know, reprint deserving for sure, since it is kind of out there as being a more older set as well. And we have a good number of cards still to go through. I'd say we're about halfway through the total list I made. But going off of, we were on main booster packs for a good while now. Some of the side Legendary Duelist packs have either, you know, gone completely out of printing or just that much more difficult to gain access to. I was going to have Ancient Gear Fusion on the list, but I decided to stick with Bingo Machine Go, since I would say Blue Eyes is a little more popular of a deck. And the fact that they made a Duelist pack with the sole intention of being able to pull these Blue Eyes cards and build the Blue Eyes deck. If someone today were to build Blue Eyes, it'd be a lot more difficult just to gain access to Bingo Machine for its price and the fact that it's a definite three of in the deck. I don't know if there's any plans for a Blue Eyes deck to come out anytime soon for a potential reprint of this card. I just know it's extremely difficult for cards in Duelist packs to be reprinted anytime sooner than they already were. Even cards from the first Legendary Duelist pack, we have cards like the Amazonas Princess, Legendary Fisherman, Citadel Whale, cards that aren't as expensive, but we haven't seen any reprints for those either. Not sure what the go-about way to do that would be either with these packs. So the scary thing is, I'm not sure when we'll see a Bingo Machine Go reprint, but one of the more stable cards definitely for the Blue Eyes deck search-wise. So if it has any potential for any of those cards in Legendary Duelist 3 to be reprinted, I think this is a definite must for sure. We've seen plenty of Chaos Blue Eyes reprints. I feel, you know, this card just as well deserves it. And also, obviously, Alternative Dragon, maybe, too, since it's really only had the Movie Pack Booster, and I know they've re-released the Movie Pack Booster plenty of times. That's why I didn't decide to put that on this list instead, just for the fact that that card and pack are still easy to access. Not so much as the Legendary Duelist 3, though. Some other ones. We have a tied spot for this. Cosmo Tin Can and Cosmojo, both coming from the Breakers of Shadow booster pack. We've seen Cosmo cards reprinted in Gold Series, which they don't really do as much anymore. But I thought with some of the other packs coming out, we would at least see a little bit of Cosmo support released for these cards. Cosmojo, Tin Can, you name it. The fact that these cards are not reprinted, but still definitely needed. The fact that they've released Dark Destroyer off the ban list. We need cards that just, you know, can help the deck out more and a little more easier access. It's much easier to get Strawmen and Farm Girls for the deck, but if you really want to play the deck at full power, you need your Tin Cans, and I know a lot of the decks do like to run the Cosmojo card as well. So whether we see these just like as an OTS pack, I know that's usually my go-to answer for a reprint, but definitely is helpful when we need some of these more expensive cards easier available to people that regular locals and as such. Now, some other ones that have been seeing some more play from Shining Victories, we have a Morphage Sloth. This one actually was used quite recently, spiked in popularity with a lot of the Pendulum decks, just for the fact that it can shut down the extra deck. Pretty good against opponents that really go for the link-heavy decks, for sure. So this card, definitely worthy, maybe, of, you know, just a reprint. Even super-wise, it was already released as Secret Highest Rarity we have, but needing just, you know, another option to pull this card and use, if not just for the Amorphage deck, but just for that extra Pendulum option, definitely needed for sure with this card. A few remaining ones that I wanted to speak of. Same treatment as Amorphage Sloth, just with the difficulty in Secret Rares, Hidden City, and all the Subterror support we've been receiving also. Just another needed card if you're going to play the deck at full power. A little more easier access to get a card. Such important as the Hidden City for a deck to use. It's, like I said, its main field spell, and definitely needs easier access. A lot of these you know, cards that were printed in these sets and are more specific for a type of deck, whether they're going to give support in another pack for it, I think would be the easiest way to get the card, but definitely, you know, cards like this need that reprint status. Now, some other ones, Meteor Black Comet Dragon, Speed Duel is a big thing, and I know we have a Joey pack on the way. If they end up giving us this card in a Speed Duel pack, that's one way to gain easier access, since you can use Speed Duel packs with those cards. And this is just a card that I could see having that option if they want to give us a card this insane in Speed Duel so early. That'd be probably one mistake on their end, but still an easy answer to reprint, because we've had plenty of other Red Eyes cards and Legendary decks reprinted otherwise. And just to end off the video, going off of one of our more recent packs, the the Battles of Legend Relentless Revenge. The most expensive card currently in the pack is Cyber Emergency. We've had Cyber Support reprinted and also new support in a lot of the later booster packs, and just one of the more difficult cards to get. I don't think we'll see a reprint for this anytime soon, but the price tag for this card is quite insane, and just the fact that we definitely need this card in Cyber Dragon decks, just for how much of a staple card it is, and the price tag of cards like Cyber Dragon, Cyber Dragon Infinity, much, much easier. Even the Link Monster Hertz and all those are much easier to get than this spell card, and I don't see Relentless Revenge as much anymore, so just one option I thought with this card would be cool to see this, you know, given to us. If we see any other Cyber Dragon support later down the road, I think a definite possibility would be that this card could be a reprinted card along with some other Cyber Dragon support also. But that is it for the discussion video. I know I really, ranted a lot about a lot of these cards, but reprints really do help a lot of the casual players in the game. Just makes it easier for other people to also, you know, play decks they really want to. And these were just my takes on cards that I want to be reprinted. What cards do you want to see is the big question I want to ask in the video today. Don't forget to comment down below with your opinion on what cards definitely need a reprint. And hopefully we do see some of these cards, you know, with easier access in some upcoming booster packs this year also. But until next time, please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, and Kira Twig out.